Welcome to the channel, rather dubiously called Rufioh. I'm the best YouTuber in my street, a very average player who uses this platform to trick you into thinking I'm good at and capable of playing Yugioh on any kind of level at all. Before we get started, why don't you hit subscribe for me, even if it's not because you secretly enjoy bad content, but because you pity me. I need every bit of help I can get. Hi guys, it's Joe here from Rufioh. Welcome to the channel. If this is your first time aboard, welcome aboard. Hopefully you enjoy this content. If this is not your first time on the channel, I don't know what you're doing back here. This is fucking trash content, and yet here you are. Thank you very much in either case for turning up. Of course, I implore you to hit subscribe now before it's too late and before you get fed up on my waffling and decide to leave the video. Hopefully you'll forget that you subscribed in time and we'll be able to crack on like nothing really happened. But we are getting a little bit off track here. We are here today for Invoked. The idea of this video is to give you a crash course in how to play Invoked. It is primarily used as an engine. Very rarely do we see it used in its pure form, but it does get splashed into so many different decks across so many different formats. And of course, we have the reprints upcoming this week, at the time of recording, at least. It may be out by the time this goes up. But anyway, we're getting off track again. So, you want to learn how to play the deck? Well, that's our intention today, is to teach you exactly what you should do. It's important to know the strengths and the weaknesses of the deck so that if you come up against it across the table, and maybe that's why you're here, you just want to make sure you're better prepared, then that is our aim too. We want to get you to come out of this video with a really solid basis and understanding on how the deck works, as well as we've got some sample lists at the very end, which will give you some ideas on cards that you could run and some synergy that goes on with the deck and exactly what to do. You can take those, play about with them. They are just sample lists, not perfect, but they'll give you some ideas of what to do. In any case, I'm waffling on as always, so we're going to get stuck right into the video for you now. Oh, and one last thing before I do continue. Apologies if there are any crazy noises. I do live in a very noisy house. On top of that, I have two dickhead dogs. One who decides to bark every time there's a noise outside, whether it's a fucking bird, whether it's someone opening their car door, whether someone breathes in the street, he will bark. And then we have this other idiot behind me who spends all his time licking his bollocks. He is a pug, so naturally he snores even when he's awake. So expect a bit of noise in the background. Apologies if that is the case. I will try to filter it out as best I can. But be forewarned, there may be some funny noises. I'm not dying whilst I record this. The Invoked archetype debuted into the Yu-Gi-Oh! TCG in February of 2017 in the Fusion Enforcers booster pack, which also included support for other fusion-based archetypes, including Predaplants and Fluffle. The archetype is based on Aleister Crowley and lends lots of influence from historical and mythological elements. The extra deck options are all based around Aleister, who invokes the monsters through himself using powerful spells and magic. The Staff of Aleister appears in their artworks too, which lends further evidence to this. Each of the invoked extra deck monsters require Aleister plus a single monster of their own attribute and increase in level as they go along. You can see how this works based on the table that you'll be able to see on screen now, as well as the influences for the choices for each monster. The Invoked archetype has been involved in lots of successful campaigns, including YCS tops, national and regional level wins, and just about everything in between. So what is it that makes Invoked so popular, and how is it played? The Invoked archetype doesn't work in the same way that you might expect a traditional deck to play. In fact, it can't exactly be the deck, at least in and of itself, when there's only one main decked monster, and a handful of spells and traps. You could, I suppose, theoretically find some extremely convoluted ways to play Kaliga Turbo, but that doesn't really feel like it would be particularly effective. But let's get back on track. Invoked as a whole is usually used as an engine, quite often splashing in 3 times Meltdown, 3 copies of Invocation, and 3 copies of Aleister, as well as any relevant extra deck targets. With this in mind, we've seen the engine paired with countless other decks, experimented with in just about every sense that you can think of. The engine focuses on getting a variety of utility fusion monsters, as well as recycling the resources used therein with Aleister and the Invocation spell, which allows the player to follow up with additional fusions as well as remain incredibly resourceful. The extra deck options that come with this engine offer a great variety of complementary choices that can benefit most decks depending on what attributes they can access. The Invoked archetype usually works especially well with decks that don't have as much pressure on using their normal summon. Many of the modern decks fall in line with this, which is part of the reason we see this being splashed so frequently from format to format. The engine does, like any other, have its weaknesses. Anti-fusion options like Dimensional Barrier can be problematic to deal with, and anything that prevents special summoning like Fossil Diner and such, Cosmic Cyclone, or anything that can banish Invocation Spell can be difficult to deal with as well, because this breaks the recycling pattern. Finally, cards that prevent banishing can also be difficult to handle, as well as cards like Artifact Lancia, Imperial Iron Wall, and Chaos Hunter. Next, we're going to do a rundown of the invoked monsters and what they do. Following this, we'll be taking a look at the in-archetype spell and trap support. As always with these videos, I'll be glossing over the effects of cards in an effort to save some time. They will, however, be shown on the screen for your perusal. It is advised that you read these cards as and when they're shown so you can be clear on precisely how the text is written. But given that you're a Yu-Gi-Oh player, we both know that you likely won't be reading a fucking thing. We start off with Alistair the Invoker. Quick effect. You can send it from the hand to the graveyard to boost the attack and defense of a fusion monster you control by 1,000 until the end of the turn. If it's normal summoned or flip face up, you can add one copy of Invocation from your deck to your hand. Next up we have Alistair the Invoker of Madness. It's a link 2 which requires two monsters with different types and different attributes. Its name becomes Alistair the Invoker whilst it's on the field or in the graveyard. If a monster is fusion summoned while you control this card except during the damage step, you can discard a card to add a copy of Invocation or the Book of the Law from your deck to your hand. If it leaves the field because of an opponent's card effect, you can add Omega Summon from the deck to the hand. And now we move on to the Invocation fusion monsters. And we start off with Invoked Kaliga. It requires Alice the Invoker and one Dark Monster. The wording on this is a pain in the arse, so in short, if a player tries to activate a monster effect, then for the rest of the turn, that player's monsters can't activate anymore. Each player can attack with only one monster during each battle phase. To clarify both of those things, if your opponent uses something and you negate it, they can't then activate further monster effects. Also, if you have something like Purgatorium on the field, it can still attack multiple times because it's the only monster you attack with, as an example. Next we have Invoked Raijin. It requires Alistair the Invoker plus a wind monster. Once per turn, during either player's turn, you can Book of Moon an opponent's monster. Invoked
Cocktease.
It requires Alistair and one water monster. It can't be destroyed or targeted by opponent's card effects. It can also attack while in face-up defense position, and if it does, you apply it to tag for damage calculation. Next we have Invoked Purgatrio. It requires Alistair plus a fire monster. It gains 200 attack for each card the opponent controls. You can attack all the opponent's monsters once each. It also inflicts piercing damage. Next up we have Invoked Magellene. It requires one copy of Alistair the Invoker plus one earth monster. This one you should be okay with understanding. The text isn't too complicated since it doesn't fucking say anything. Invoked Ogaway.
He's nuts! Got him! Got him!
It requires Alistair plus a fusion monster. If it's special summoned or a monster is special summoned to the opponent's field, you can pop an opponent's monster. This effect is a hard once per turn. Once per turn, you can banish a fusion monster from your graveyard, and this card gains attack equal to that banished monster's attack until the end of the opponent's turn. Next up, we have Invoked Mekk-Knight. Alistair plus one light monster. Once per turn, when a spell, trap, or monster effect is activated, quick effect, you can send the same type of card from your hand to the graveyard to negate and banish that card. And lastly, we have Invoked Elysium. It requires one invoked monster plus one monster that was special summoned from the extra deck. As a quick note on those requirements, the monster that is special summoned from the extra deck does not include monsters in the graveyard, as these are no longer recognized as being summoned from the extra deck. It must first be fusion summoned with the above materials. While it's face up on the field, it's also considered to be dark, earth, water, fire, and wind. Once per turn, during either player's turn, you can target an invoked monster you control or in your graveyard, banish it, and all monsters your opponent controls with the same attribute as that monster. Yes, you can target this on the field and banish basically almost any number of monsters your opponent controls simultaneously. Alistair as the main deck monster is usually a 3 of in any engine, along with copies of Purgatrio and Mekkaba being the most common extra deck choices, but otherwise it largely boils down to space and preference and the deck which it's being melded with. For the next part, we'll be covering the spells and traps. Few as they may be, these all can be relevant depending on the deck, although largely we just see Invocation and Magical Meltdown seeing the most play. So naturally, we do start off with Invocation itself. Fusion summon a fusion monster from the extra deck using monsters from your hand as fusion material. If this is used for summoning an invoked monster, you can also banish monsters from your field and or either player's graveyard as material. If this card is in your graveyard, you can add back a banished Alistair the Invoker to your hand, then shuffle this into the deck. This effect is a hard once per turn. We then have Magical Meltdown. When it's activated, you can add a copy of Alistair the Invoker from the deck to the hand. The activation of your cards and effects that fusion summon a fusion monster can't be negated. Also, your opponent's cards and effects can't activate when a monster is fusion summoned in this way. You can only activate one copy of Meltdown per turn. We have Book of the Law. You can tribute an invoked monster to special summon an invoked monster from the extra deck with a different original attribute from the tributed monster that is treated as a fusion summon. You can only activate one copy of Book of the Law per turn. And lastly, we have our solitary trap choice, one that doesn't really see all that much play, Omega Summon. Special summon any number of your banished invoked monsters with different names in defense position. Now we move on to our final part of this video. Normally at this stage we'd look at giving you some common support cards for a given deck, but since this doesn't make up a whole deck of its own, we'll skip over this. You can look to add additional fusion support, but that's about where this ends. Next up instead, we'll show you a variety of sample lists from common deck combinations you might see which pairs with Invoked. These are just sample lists, so keep that in mind that they won't be perfectly refined. And also keep in mind that from format to format and over time, the value of these lists provided will fluctuate. Having said that, the intention is to provide you with some examples of something you can build from, and these might be a good starting point for you. Thank you. that is all for today's video, guys. Thank you very much for making it this far. I really appreciate it. Even though it is absolute garbage content, you somehow made it all the way to the very end. So hopefully you're feeling a little bit better prepared for this deck, whether it's to use the deck or whether it's to play against the deck. Again, if you haven't already, you should most definitely have hit subscribe already. We do tons of content on here. Monday Night Market Watches for the Euro content. We do more of these how to play videos. We've got deck profiles, combo tutorials. If there's anything you want to see, feel free to go ahead and request it, and we'll see what can be done. Thank you very much again for checking in, guys, and I will see you in the next one. Thank you for watching. Hopefully you've enjoyed the garbage content I put together for you. Enough to hit subscribe and maybe even drop a thumbs up and a comment. Before you go, be sure to check out the links in the description to help support the people who are making this channel a possibility. Thanks again for checking in, and I'll see you in the next one.